Before I start, I must thank the organizer, Dr. Nimaijan Saha, the university librarian, who has taken this initiative to organize this webinar series. And equally congratulate Jayakumar Sharma and Sujit Ujur for hosting this webinar successfully. And it's glad to see so many participants, so that we have to organize one more. So today's topic is role of remote access and discovery services in research. So as you can, this topic will be delivered in three parts. First, there will be a presentation, as you can see through the PPT. So after the presentation, I will show you the online demo. And after the online demo, we will go for question answer series. So all the participants are requested to keep your question answers ready. Meanwhile, you are seeing the presentation. If you have any queries, if you have any questions, keep ready your questions. So after the presentation is over and online demo is over, you can clarify your doubts. So coming back to the presentation, as you can see, there is a picture of an iceberg. So what I'm trying to show is that whenever you are accessing the library, Vishwabharati Library Network, throughout the from Central Library, or there are 13 sectional libraries. So with one library card, you can access all the resources of Central Library as well as all the 13 sectional library throughout the campus. When you are physically accessing the library, you are just accessing this 10% of the iceberg. That means physically, whatever you can see is only the 10% of the resources of Vishwabharati Library Net. The rest amount of the 90% of the iceberg, the 90% of the resources of the Vishwabharati are in the form of e-resources. So when we started this remote access, it was started keeping in mind that the research scholars, the part-time research scholars, or the full-time research scholars who are going is, or whenever the teachers or are going abroad for conferences and all that, so they can access all the resources of Vishwabharati through this remote access. But in this time of lockdown, it is very much essential to use this remote access, and I'm very hopeful that after seeing the presentation, you will request for the remote access account, and you will surely go for the discovery services for helping your research or for writing your articles. So whatever we are going to present today is about the remote access and the discovery services. So remote access is also known as Open Athens. So Open Athens and remote access are basically same thing. So remote access basically means library goes where you go. Access all the online journals, databases, and ebooks from anywhere in the globe, at any time, from any network provider. What you will have to do, you will have to make a request, email request to the librarian, NC Saha. So the email number is given over here. You can note it down. You will have to give an email request to the librarian with an ID and some mandatory pieces of information for an undertaking that you are going to use these resources, but that will be a fair use. So you will have to copy and paste the undertaking in the email message. I will show what is the undertaking. So you will have to copy and paste the undertaking in the email message, and it will not be sent as an attachment. So this access will be granted for a limited period, but as many times as required. And you are fortunate enough that is only open for the faculty and research scholars. So on the creation of an account, you will receive an email asking to activate the same and create the password. So whenever you have, I believe that most of you have used the Vishwabharati Library Network. This is our library network site. So in the library network site also, we have provided this remote access facility, and this is all about how to open your remote access account. As I told you, you will have to give an email request to the librarian and he will give you. So this is the undertaking with your name. You will have to give this undertaking before creating your account. So sending an email request to the librarian that I want the remote access so that I can access all the e-resources sitting back at my home during this lockdown period. So this undertaking is necessary, and these are the words that you will have to give. That suppose you propose some user ID with your name, you can propose this user ID, your personal detail, your name, department, your position, whether you are a research scholar, whether you are a faculty, your phone number, your email ID. If you are a faculty, your staff employee ID will be there. So with that and address, you can send a request, email request to the librarian, and he will provide you the remote access facility. So whenever we are going to give you the remote access, we are taking the undertaking. Why we are taking? Because when we have received several complaints from the consortium, the provider of the e-resources, that the whole document, the whole book has been downloaded. So whenever we are giving this remote access, or whenever you are going to use this remote access, you'll have to keep some points in your mind that we are going to use this e-resources for a fair use. It cannot be used for a commercial purpose. So the doctrine that brief exports of copyright material may be under certain circumstances. So these are the things, and for fair use of e-resources of Vishwabharati Library Network. E-resources will be used for academic uses only. Downloading, printing a single copy is permissible, but downloading or printing the entire book or entire issues or volumes of the journals is strictly prohibited. So these things should be kept in mind, and that comes under the fair systematic coding using robot and other intelligent agent access or search is strictly prohibited. So any violation of this policy may result in penal action as per the university rules. So systematic downloading will cause the publisher to block the entire community of Vishwabharati from accessing these resources. So at this time of lockdown, when we can use the e-resources sitting back at home, we can provide as many articles, we can, the research scholars can enhance their researches. So we should find that our fair use of the e-resources will help the other users of the BB community, so that our simple mistakes cannot block the entire community of Vishwabharati from accessing these resources. So how much is too much? So in case of motion media, in case of all the resources, whatever we are providing for the Sangeet Bhavan also, we are providing for the Kala Bhavan also, we are providing for all the research scholars and faculties of the Vishwabharati. So they have motion media, they have text media, they have music, video, lyrics and music, photographs, numerical data. So in case, what is the fair use or how much is too much, we should keep in mind that up to, in case of motion media, up to the 10% or 3 minutes of a work, whichever is less, is a fair use. In case of text material, up to 10%, 1,000 words, whichever is less. In case of music, lyrics or music video, up to 10%, but not more than 30 seconds. In case of illustration and photographs, no more than 5 images of an artist or photographer. And when using material from a published collective work, not more than 10% or 15 MHS, whichever is less. In case of numerical data set, up to the 10% or 2500 fields or whichever is less. So on logging the Open Athens, I will show you the online demo after the presentation is over. After the PPT is over, I will go for the online demonstration. So whenever we are logging to the Open Athens, we will have to go for My Athens and we will have to start the search. So two search facilities are there. One is Discovery Services search and other is individual database search. Since we are not in the campus right now, we are not accessing. Whenever we are in the campus, we have to use this link. Since we are using from our home, so we are going for the Open Athens. So this screen will come to you whenever we request to the librarian. And on getting this Open Athens account, you will, from Google, if you are going to open the Open Athens, you will see this screen. Your email address and password will be there, so you can sign in like any other account you are signing, like your Gmail account, you're giving the email address and password, then you are signing. Likewise, the Open Athens will be there. Now coming to the Discovery Service. The first part was remote access. What is remote access and how to create the account? So the remote access is for those who cannot directly physically access the library. So you, during this lockdown period from your home, you are accessing the remote access. You are accessing all the resources from sitting back at your home. So you will send the email request to librarian, you will get your remote access account and you can access all the resources. That part is over and we have talked about the fair uses. Now we are coming to the Discovery Services. This is a wonderful service and I must suggest you should use it. Unless and otherwise you use it, you cannot see the magnificent feel it has. And in a very short span of time, you will get the accurate information and there are many parameters through which you can filter your search. So it is a wonderful, really wonderful service and you should use it. You should try this. So this a short brief introduction about this Discovery Service. This service has been commissioned on 30th March 2015. Since 2015, the Vishwabharati Library Network and all the users are beneficiary of this Discovery Service. A tool that crawls through almost all library resources so that they can be explored using a single search box. It aids in retrieval of information from thousands of online searches, including free and open databases and ebooks by single search. Detailed write-up is there on the library website. Today we will discuss about it. So it is I have given the picture of so many watches. So it is a very much time saving. Whenever we are searching in a Google, so there can be some authentic, some cannot be unauthenticated information. But this Discovery Services provide all the authenticated information within a limited period of time and with so many filters, so that according to your language, according to your preference, according to your, if you are searching some documents, if you're belonging to a history, if you're searching something very long back, you can filter the research according to show you. So this is our Vishwabharati Library Network site. And hopefully if the lockdown is over and when we are going to library physically, so this is the Library Network site. And within this menu, under this service menu, the Discovery Services is provided. Since 2015, we are providing. So when through Vishwabharati Library Network, this is the link provided. from where we have to go. And this is the Discovery Services single window searching facility of the Discovery Services. This is the and see, I have given a search research methodology. See, the number of result is as shown. This number of result it has given, and you can see these are the parameter I was talking about. If you want to see full text, if you want to see the peer review, if you want to see catalog only, and this is the publication date. As I told you, if you belonging to a, so if you are belonging to a history background, or if you are searching something back, long back publication date, so you can delimit this publication date so that previous or very historical or very past records will be shown to you. So from newspaper, from different article, from different ebooks will be shown to you. Now I will take you to the online demo. I have created my OpenAthens account. So once you get your remote access account, so as I show you in the PPT, log into MyAthens. So I am going to the log into MyAthens. Once you have requested the for the remote access, you will be given an account name, and you have to create your own password for the security purposes, and the password should be very strong. So now this my username and password is there since I am using this one long. So now as I showed you in the PPT through the library website, when we are going to the library physically, we are accessing the resources and through the library website, and those were the slides, those were the site which you can see through the library when you are there in physically in the library. In Athens account, these are all the resources which you can use sitting back at your home, and this is the Discovery Services single window search. So if I want to search something on education, you will be surprised to see the number of results it has shown, and I'm sure you will get the open at see the number of results it is showing. And I was talking about the parameters. See, these are the parameters. If you want to see the full text, see the number of the result. How will it change when we are filtering it to the different parameters? See the full text. If I want to see only the full text, then the numbers will automatically diminish. See, it has diminished. Now again, if I want to see something very recently published, and I am delimiting or filtering this publication date. Suppose I want to see something from 1950 to 2021, in between. See, the number has diminished. And since I cannot read all the languages, okay, if I want to delimit, if I want to do it only in the English languages, the language option is there. So if you want to see the articles only in English languages, so again, this, as you can see, this we have delimited the number, we have filtered it according to full text only. We are asking for the full text from the discovery services, so it has delimited to the full text within a second. And again, we have filtered it according to the publication date. So this number has diminished. So only the within this time period, the published article or the published books, published books has been shown over here. And again, keep in mind this numericals. Again, I am delimiting it according to the language. I want to see only the things published, which is so automatically this number is diminishing, right? So if you want something from the academic journals, so this number of results will come. If you want something from the magazines, sometimes what happened, the people search something in the archives, they want something, some news clippings. So you can click to the news. If you want some reports, you can click to the filters of the reports. If you want something on the reviews, you can click on that. In what sense you are talking about the education? If you are talking about the education in terms of library and information science, the education in terms of higher education, the education in terms of book reviews, the news, opinion and commentary, I'm clicking for library information science. The education of librarian and information science. So see, the number of result has already diminished, and I can get globalizing music education. So these are the result. So again, we have taken only English. Now, if I want to see something which is published within India, or within West Bengal, or within something, so geographical parameters are also there. So what about the education of library information science in the United States? What about the education of library information science in the United Kingdom? What about in Canada? What about in New York, California? So there are many other. So these are the geographical parameters where from these data has been collected. So if I want to see something in United States, so what is the scenario of library information in over there? What is going on? And if I want to see the education in publishing industry, if I want to see the education in business, if I want to see the education as company business management, company website or web page, market trend and market analysis. So according to the publisher, if I want to see some, if I have something particular about some publisher, then we can search for that. We can according to that, so whatever your research topic is, or in case of faculty, their research interest is, so they can search the term within this box. After that, they can delimit it to the whether they want. They can also want some, apart from full text, they can also search for abstract also. So you can delimit it. You can delimit according to the subject. You can verify your research, what is according to your particular subject, according to the particular publisher, within the geographical parameters. So these are the filterization of the parameters on the left hand side. And again, we have some parameters on the right hand side. Suppose you are searching for some article which you through Google Scholar you can search, through Wikipedia, through YouTube, through Mendeley. If you are using the Mendeley for your citations, then you can search from these resources. This we have National Digital Library also. We have InfliptNet. So some thesis related to your topic was earlier published. So you want to see whether it is going to duplicating or not. How can it help you? So you can go for the internet also. Vidyanidhi is also. So Hong Kong Utility Thesis is also there. ETD is also there. So these are the parameters for thesis. And you have so many parameters. If you want to see the full text, you can go click on that. You can see the text of this. If you want something else, you can type your search over here. So whatever your queries are, suppose you have given participate in a seminar or something, you have been given theme and sub-theme. So you can type that theme and sub-theme over there in this search box, and the related article and related things will come. So from there you can have some ideas, you can develop your own ideas, help out these articles, and you can produce a fruitful creative work. So these are the, this result has come. So whatever you is, whatever your topic is, you can search the term. And you can search the term, and you will have the required result. And I'm sure you will find this very useful, and you will use this. So unless and until you use, you cannot see the significance of the result. So these, as a, whenever you are going to use, you can, according to your search term, you can delimit them according to the sources, sources of the research, sources type, according to your subject, according to the publisher. See, the search term has changed and the publishers related to this search term has changed. So subject, his books, reviews, his publishing industries. So from magazines, you want the this topic from magazine, from news, from academic journals, from e-books. So the publishers who have published this, are, these are the publishers. So the publications are there, the languages are there. So if you are known to these languages, you can see the Bengali language is also there, French, Spanish, English, German. So if you want something published within India, you can click on that and you can see the terms. You can see if it has come from Bangladesh or United Kingdom or United States or China or Asia. So these are the things. And once you click on the full text, if you want, so this Plum matrix is also there. So what is the relevance of this particular how many uses are there, how many citation has been given. That can be also, the usage of this can also be understood. So if so once you get the remote access facility, you can search this discovery services sitting back at your home. And this discovery facility has many more other features, so that they can autocorrect and autocomplete the whenever you are searching. Suppose you are not known to the term, so it will autocomplete, correct the terms. And we have permalink in this. You can create your own folder according to your preference. Your folder will be there. And for in case of faculty, through the permalink, the teachers can send the student for the online classes. And see, the language option is also there. So if you want, these are the language options available. So in these languages, you can search your term, and it will be of great help for the teachers, for the students to enhance their research. Some requests are coming to show the PPT. So I will show the PPTs once again. So the remote access means you can access the library sitting back at your home when during this lockdown period. You can create your own article, as many articles as you want. So for the remote access, you access the discovery services for a single window search. So we have so many facilities to filterize all the your search term. You can filterize your search term according to the publication date, according to your requirement. So that to access the discovery services, you can go for the, you can request, you can request the librarian for opening or getting your Open Athens or remote access account. So in our Vishwabharati Library Network, we have given this, we have been facilitating to provide, use the remote access. So before the lockdown, since we have been using this remote access since 2015, so many faculties who are going abroad for conferences and all that, they have been using this Open Athens remote access resources. And many research scholars during this vacations time, they have been also using the remote access for a long time, so that sitting at home, they can enhance their researches. And so this is the undertaking. Many have been asking for this undertaking. So this undertaking you have to give in your email, as not as attachment, within the text when you are requesting for the remote access, give this to the with the email request for opening the remote access. You give this undertaking, so your account will be there. You will, within 24 hours, the librarian will provide you the account, but it will be provided for a limited time. And after getting the account, you can access the all the e-resources, and you can search through the single window search of discovery services, which you will find very useful, beneficial, especially this during this lockdown period. And fair use, we should keep in mind that whenever we are using these e-resources, we are not going to hamper the Vishwa Bharati Library Network or the So whenever we are using this, we are not going to infringement of the copyright act. So keeping in that mind, because infringement of the publisher will block the entire community of the Vishwa Bharati. So we do not want that. Keeping in mind the use of fair use, that copyright is not infringed. So guidelines of fair use of e-resources of Vishwa Bharati Library Network. Earlier, we have received some complaints from the publishers that the entire document has been downloaded or the entire book has been downloaded. So that should not be repeated once again. And earlier back, we had been blocked by the publisher, the entire community was blocked. So we should keep in mind, so this fair use should be there. We can downloading or printing or single copy is permissible, but the entire book or entire issue or volume of journal is strictly prohibited. We should keep in mind. And systematic downloading using robot and other intelligent agents to access a research is strictly prohibited. So any violation may result in the penal action as per the university. So how much is too much? So this is there. The increase of motion media, text material, music lyrics, music video, illustration, photograph, numerical data sets. So many questions come. So during this lockdown period, if you want to use the discovery services, then you have to get the remote access, because during this lockdown period, we cannot open the homepage, which I showed you in the slide. So as I show you during the online demo, that on logging into when I got my remote access account, so on going to the Open Athens, I clicked on My Athens and started the search on the discovery service. So this is the site where you can give your username and password to get into the Open Athens. And this EBSCO host is providing the discovery service. So this single window search. See, earlier I gave research methodology. So many articles have come down, so many e-books, e-resources have come down on research methodology. So there are parameters like full text as I shown you. So now I can ask if you have any questions, you can go on with that. So whatever I spoke, whether it was understood by you or not, I am not sure. But one thing I'm sure that you will use the remote access to get the discovery services. And once you are using the discovery services, you will become habitual. You will not go anywhere else. I'm sure about that. Because from when we have started discovery services, we are not going anywhere else. And for our academic publications and all that, we are totally reliable and totally dependent on the discovery services. So once you will use it, you will become dependent on that. I'm sure about it. So you can ask your questions. What are your doubts? You can please clear your doubts.
Thank you, ma'am Sabah, for your nice deliberation regarding your topic. And I think most of our participants are enriched a lot. And I think they have so many queries regarding the presentation, the service provided by the Librarian Network. And nowadays, during the lockdown, our computer center is off. That's why our website is not functioning.
Yes.
This is one thing you should note. But remote access is the way you can use our resources, as Madam is shown to you. So now I am going to open the house for the discussion. You may raise your question one by one, and rest others, please put off the audio. That's so that anyone can hear clearly, and she can explain, and you can hear everything nicely. So now I'm going to unmute you all. So you may raise your question and Sawat will happy to answer you. Now you can ask the questions.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Hello. Ma'am, I wanted to know if if a book is important, firstly, I downloaded one chapter, but the whole book is important. How should I go about it?
In case of fair use, the entire book cannot be downloaded.
Okay,
you can just see that book.
That's there. So,
the book will be there on the screen. So, whatever important is to you, you can note it down. Right. During our student period also, we used to write so many things. But it is good to write down things from there and start filing everything up. So the book will be there on the screen. 10% you can download.
Hello.
The 90% of the book. Can you hear me? Hello? Can you hear me?
No, ma'am. I could not hear you.
May I interfere, Sabat?
Yes, can you hear? Yes,
madam,
you?
Can you show her how to search through open access? It means how to search a book and how much they can download. You just show in practical so she can understand nicely. I think our question is directly related to how to download or access a book through open access.
So in case of this book, this is our project. So in case of one ebook I'm showing you, so only the 10% you should keep in mind, you are downloading only the 10%. And regarding the 90%, you can note it down. Things. So this book is provided by Springer Link. We are going to that. So So these are the matters of the book. Can you see?
Yes, ma'am.
So these are the matters. So which part you find relevant? So the download option is there.
Acha kung bapa na huwag na, kung bapa na huwag. Read John, did you like na kaya hin? Read John, hala kaya na hapo. Read John, did you like na kaya hin? Ano ba yung read John? Sam niyong kaya na huwag eh.
So the abstract is given over there. So there are about 6 chapters. So the PDF is there.
What are your wants?
Hi, hope you have got your answer.
Yes, ma'am.
Power to chole jabe.
Yes, any more questions?
Any more questions?
Any more questions?
One thing you should note down that you can able to download those books only which are subscribed by the library or purchased by the library.
Exactly.
So remote access does not mean that every resource we can download.
Any more questions from the audience? Some has sent in the chat box, you think?
वो तो चैट बॉक्स का जवाब बाद में
यस इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन यू कैन आल्सो रेज योर क्वेश्चन इन इन द चैट बॉक्स आल्सो इवन यू कैन सेंड ईमेल टू मैडम साबर सो शी कैन रिप्लाई यू अकॉर्डिंगली इज देयर एनी मोर क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द पार्टिसिपेंट्स
ठीक है
नहीं तो sir, do we have to renew our open access account? I mean, during this period, or are we supposed to do it when the university starts?
You may, if your login is not working, you can renew by sending email to our deputy library. Sorry, our librarian Nimaida. He will. Again, reactivate your email in your account.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yes.
Okay. Hello.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, suppose if I have an account and I didn't renew it for 6 months, so.
Hello.
Can you repeat your question again?
Hello. Can you repeat the question?
Hello, can you repeat your question?
More question.
I think he's asking that if we if we do not use our account for long, what would be the status of the account? Abad, can you answer? Or should I?
Pardon, I could not get that question.
The question is maybe that if anyone not use for a long time, what happened about the account? If you, maybe okay, it is okay. Discontinued or like that. So in that case, what?
The account may have become dormant, so that you will have to request once again. So you had an account earlier, but you have not used it for a long time. So that may, your account may have become dormant. You can send an email request again to the librarian. He will provide you another account.
Okay, okay. Well, okay, I will get a new account then.
Not yes, new account, yes. You just renew that.
That same okay, account will get activated.
Maybe that you have to create a new password.
Sometimes we have so many accounts, we forget the passwords. So you'll have to change the password in that case. Any other questions? One question in the chat box is lying that how many pages or chapters can be downloaded at any time? Physically, it's 20 pages for Xerox. So only the 10%, as I told you, is the fair use. So only the 10% of the resources you can download. And the rest part, you can note down the important things in your notebook. Any other question?
Yes, बहुत सारे resources हैं available. जितना भी repository सब discovery service में किया हुआ.
And one question has there, this open discovery service is open source or not? So this is not an open source. This discovery services, the Vishwabharati Library Network has bought for a huge amount, so that the users can be benefit, can take the benefits. So this discovery service is not at all an open source. You will have to go through the remote access network to access this discovery services. We have paid a huge amount to get this software. So I think you will get the benefit for that from that. And it is very useful. Any other questions?
Prashun Kanti Goshal, have you any questions?
Sujitda,
yes,
I have a question.
Yeah, yeah.
That in this lockdown period, PG and UG students can get the remote access on request, special request. Hello.
Actually, this question is, I think, directly you may ask from the librarian. He will give you the exact okay. answer. But as for my knowledge, this service is not meant for UG and PG students.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, okay, some limitation.
No, it's not provided for UG and PG level, but it is available for MPhil, PhD, and for the faculty and for the officers.
Okay, but, okay.
No new kind of regulation or not change have made yet, as for my knowledge.
Okay.
For that, you okay. ask, you, anyone can contact with the librarian. If he feel it is required, so maybe he can provide the link or access.
Okay, okay. As a special case.
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay. Thank you, Sujitda. Thank you, Sabad Madam.
Most welcome.
Okay.
So once again, I repeat, if you have any questions, you can ask to Madam Sabat, or you can send your questions in the chat box, or you can directly send email to Sabat Madam. So you can get your answer. We will definitely provide you the answer. I think there is no more question.
So can we wind up?
Yeah. So thank you very much, Sawat, for your nice and informative deliberation of burning topic, remote access and discovery service. This will help in this during this lockdown period to our users, our faculty, our researchers for their academic activities so that they can continue in their academic work without any break. So once again, all the participants, now we are winding up the session. Thank you very much and stay.
Thank you, Sujitha.
Thank you. Thank you, Sawat. Thank you all.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.